So I have few points of my own to share. We have been getting calls and everything related to, and a lot of messages also related to how you can improve, what are the correct answers, what we should do, and all these things. So I'll keep it very brief, how you can improve. So first thing is confidence and communication is the key. If you see your feedback with Naveen sir, most of you have actually, you are either lacking confidence or there's a gap in communication, right? What do you want to say something, sometimes you communicate it differently. So confidence and communication is the key. So even if you're lying, you have to have confidence. You have to have this confidence and communication because that will only take you forward. So, and how do you build confidence and how do you build communication? It comes eventually. It's not today, actually. Today I'm confident, tomorrow I won't be confident. If you're confident, you're confident. That's it. And it will develop slowly. Most of you are becoming confident. So it will come slowly. It's okay. And communication also improves. Second thing is keep your answers short and crisp with clarity. So most of you are giving very long answers. Like, it's huge. You're taking a lot of time. The interviewers get bored or they get, swayed away. They lose you in the middle of the answer. So how do you do that? I'll come to that later on also. How do you keep your answers short and crisp? So third thing is know your know basic answers. Well, introduction. You have other things such as MP, MLA. Your representatives. All these things. These fall under basic answers. So please, have these basic answers. Write it down. Most of you are missing that. You're not writing it down. So please write that down first. The way you prepared for the first paper. I don't know, but I think you are taking it too casually because you think class is, enough. But it's not enough. You have to do some background checks. You have to do some homeworks as well. Naveen sir and I, we had prepared for GDPI in the same, enthusiasm we had prepared for the first part, because second part gets very difficult. Yes, right. It's very difficult because you have all the creamy people there now, because though all of them have been selected for the second round. All of them are eligible. All of them have the same quality as you, right? So you have to work extra hard right now. And one more thing that most of you miss is you do not practice. If you go from the inception of the class, when you started the class, there are a lot of questions for the person interview, a lot of questions for the GD. Gather it all together, bring it all together, compile it, and start working on those. We had to research, we had to do, find and, brainstorm before we gave you those questions. It took a lot of energy from us, right? That means those questions are very good. We had taken consultations even from the alumni who have already passed. We had taken consultations even from the faculties, right? So practice those questions, and compile those questions. You can take help of each other, you can coordinate with each other, and then you compile those questions for GD, for PI, and then start working on those. And last thing is, as I said, like what you have to do. So write, revise, and practice. Write down all the questions for GD as well as PI. Revise it. See where you're going, you're speaking something extra that is not required. Especially in PI, you elongate your answers a lot. See where you can cut it out. But that will only come after you have written it down. Once you write it down, you can revise it. You can see, okay, so there is something, sorry, there's something you can cut it out. You can, brief it. But first write all the answers. The process is first write all the answers and then go to revision. And then you practice it. So that's all from my side. I think these are the five things that you should do to improve your performance in PI.
Okay, sir. Thank you.